Hey Flob! So Qosmetics, which is Custom Sabers, just updated like 2 days ago. It was a super fast update for version 127. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to mod version 127 and how to install Custom Sabers. If you wanted to have chroma and wall maps to go along with your Custom Sabers though, you will still have to downgrade as of right now. I'll keep the pinned comment up to date with that information. I do have downgrade and chroma tutorials on the channel, so check those out if you were trying to get wall maps. And if you're interested in other Quest 2 tutorials or just VR content in general, definitely check out the rest of the channel. If you've never modded before, it's super important that you watch the full video, because there are a lot of steps in the modding process, and if you miss even one, it will cause an error. And as much as I love hearing from you guys in the comments, about 80% of the troubleshooting comments I get are already answered in the video.
Listen.
Okay, for this tutorial, you're going to need a computer or laptop, a Type-C cable, your Quest 2 headset, the device that you have your Quest app installed on, and you're also going to need access to a Discord account. Step one is creating and enabling a developer account. So type this into your search browser or click the link in the description below. You'll need to go ahead and log in if you're not already, and then you should be met with this page here. You're going to click the drop down in the top left corner and then hit create. You can select any organization name you like. And then make sure you read everything before you agree. Hit submit. And then again, make sure you read all of the information here and hit agree and submit again. Power on your Quest 2 headset, then open up your Quest app, click on menu and then devices. Then scroll down to headset settings, click on developer, and then make sure it's enabled. Next, we need to make sure that app sharing is turned off and that there are no other accounts linked, because it will prevent you from modding your game if you have it on or you have accounts linked. But Christopher did give us some information on our last video. They were able to turn app sharing back on after they modded their game, and their second account was able to play Beat Saber on an unmodded version. Just make sure you turn it off for this tutorial first and then turn it back on when you're done. So we're gonna click on quick settings and then go to settings, and then we're gonna go to accounts and make sure that app sharing here is turned off so it's not blue and that your account is the only one showing. If there are other accounts, make sure you unlink them and turn this off. Next up is Sidequest, which allows us to install BMBF on our headset so we can get the modded Beat Saber. So go ahead and type this into your search browser or click the link in the description below. Okay, we're going to click the download for the advanced installer. Once it's done downloading, go ahead and run the app. Click next and choose what location you want it to install to and then hit install. Okay, now that Sidequest is installed, we need to connect our headset. So go ahead and plug your Quest 2 into your PC, and you're gonna get a pop-up window that asks you to allow connected device to access the files. You wanna say allow. And there's been times where I've gotten more than one pop-up. Just make sure you allow all of them. After you've done that, you should see that you're showing connected in the top left corner of Sidequest. If you're not showing connected, then you need to make sure that you've allowed all the notifications in the headset when you plug it in. Then in the search bar, type in BMBF, and then click download app. You should see it say success in the bottom right corner when it's done. I'm gonna show you how to save your player data settings and like avatar settings, stuff like that. Click on manage files on the headset, which is the little folder in the top right. And then you're gonna click on Android, data, Beat Games, files. And here we're gonna wanna save avatar. We're gonna hit the little floppy disk looking guy. And I'm going to put these on my desktop, and I'm just gonna make a new folder. And I'm just gonna go ahead and name it Quest Files. And we're gonna save that one. And then we need player data. Same location. And then the settings CFG. Let's move over to the headset. Now, in your headset, from the app library, go to all in the top right corner, all the way down to unknown sources, and then launch BMBF. Then you'll get the setup screen, and I encourage you to read everything as we go along through the prompts. I'm just gonna fly through it, but it'll be helpful for you to understand if it's your first time modding, like how the process works. And you wanna make sure that it says your version of Beat Saber, which currently we're on 127.0, is supported by BMBF. So then we can hit get started. And then we'll uninstall Beat Saber. And this part does take a little while, so you're just gonna have to wait for it to finish. And we'll hit okay. And then patch Beat Saber. Okay, then install modded Beat Saber. If you get this pop-up, you'll have to click on settings, toggle allow on, and then hit back. And then you'll have to re-prompt it. Install. If you get this pop-up that says the package installer isn't responding, you're gonna hit wait. All right, then you'll probably get a pop-up that says restore the app, it's unofficial. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna hit close because if you hit restore, you're gonna unmod your game. Hit done from this menu, don't open Beat Saber yet. And then if BMBF does what mine just did and stays on this page, we're gonna close it and just relaunch it. You should get this menu here. If you've modded before, you'll have this option to restore your playlist. If you haven't modded, then don't worry about that. So now we're gonna hit sync to Beat Saber. If you see failed to install core mods right here, when you hit sync or for some reason your sync button isn't there, we're gonna click on tools and then scroll down and hit check core mod updates. So let's hit sync again. BMBF kept failing to install the core mods for me. I don't know if it's because I've modded before, but if any of you are having the same issue, all I had to do was restart my headset, and then I went back into BMBF on the tools page and then click the check for core mods update, and then I was able to launch Beat Saber and my mods were there. Okay, now that we have core mods installed, let's get the custom Sabers mod. Go back over to questmodding.com. So you're going to click on released mods. Make sure that you're on 127 in the dropdown, or if you're on a different version, choose the right version. And then we are gonna scroll down and find Qosmetics Whackers and hit download. Okay, back in the headset again, there's a lot of back and forth, so get used to it. In BMBF, go back to the tools page, and then right here in the top corner where it says accessible via browser at HTTP, all the way to the slash here, you need to type that into your browser. Okay, this part is really important. So for the connection to work, your Quest 2 and your PC have to be on the same local network. So like sharing the same Wi-Fi, they just have to be on the same local network, okay? And then also, you have to have your headset open on the tools page in BMBF. If your headset is idling, it will not make a connection. So I keep it on my forehead so that it doesn't fall asleep. If you typed everything correctly, you should be met with this page. Now, down here, you should be showing connected. Mine isn't, and it's because my headset is idling. So put it back on my head. Oh, and look at that, it's green again. Do not let it fall asleep, otherwise it won't be connected. So the whole time this is up, we have to have this connected. Okay, so you can either click in the center or drag and drop your files. Either way, you want your whackers to go in here. You want it to say that the mod install queued and then hit sync to Beat Saber. It needs to show success for the cosmetic Sabers, otherwise the mod did not load. Now launch Beat Saber. We need to make sure the mod is there. You're gonna go to solo and then you should have a mods tab. And you should see Qosmetics Whackers right here. Okay, the mod is installed, we've confirmed that. Now we need to get some Sabers. We're gonna have to join the Qosmetics Discord server, so I put an invite to the link below. After joining the server, you're gonna go to Whackers, and this is where you're gonna find all of your custom Sabers. So you can just scroll through here and find any that look really cool to you, like this pair looks pretty cool, so I'm just gonna hit download, and then go through and find all the Sabers that you want. Make sure that you're still showing connected down here. Again, the headset can't be idling, and then you're just going to open up all of your Sabers that you picked out. Make sure that you're showing file copied. Now go back over to Whackers, and you should see all the Sabers that you just installed. We have a whole bunch of options now, so let's try these out. And there we go, now we have custom Sabers. Before we wrap this video up, I'm gonna show you how to put your player data back in so that your high scores and your avatar is back to the way it was when you first started. Okay, with Sidequest showing connected in the top left corner, you're gonna go back to that same spot we saved the files from. So go to Manage Files, Android, Data, Beat Games, Files, and then right in here, you're gonna click the plus sign and then upload file to this folder. And then you're just gonna upload all of those files that you saved. And then once they show success in the bottom right corner, your avatar settings and everything should be back where they were. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.